Trini Girl Natural.
Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I'm excited to be discussing the Jane Carter Curls to Go line. Of course, I have to tell you my little PJ story about when I first heard about the line. So, you know, I first heard about it on Instagram when the Jane Carter company posted that it's new and it's coming out and the labels were so cute and it looks so exciting. But anyway, so I really wanted to try it out, but they weren't in any stores near to me. A couple weeks back, Jane Carter announced that the Curls to Go line was going to be sold in Rite Aid. And she did a promotion saying that if you went over there and took some pictures with it, you'll get a free prize. So, of course, I went over there. That's another video coming up soon, by the way, how to get free stuff. But yeah, I checked myself over to Rite Aid and it wasn't there. I asked the manager, store manager, about it, and she was a really nice, sweet black woman, and she said she was gonna get it. So long story short, I went back last week and there was. So yay! So I picked up two items, the Untangle Me Weightless Leave-In and the Coiling All Curls Elongating Gel. So you know the usual thing with me, I looked over everything and these two had the cleanest ingredients, so I decided to try these out. So that's the story. I got home and the very next wash day, I tried it out, which is what you see here. I'm gonna just show you how I applied it, how it was to apply, and then I'm gonna come right back and get into the review. So stay tuned. So I'm starting off with trying the Untangle Me, the leave-in. You know, it reminds me of the Camero's kids line that I tried. Just good for my hair. Guess I kind of forgot to show you the before, but you saw it. Anyhow, so it goes on pretty normal, but like the more you rake it in, the more it just kind of clumps your curls. So, you know, it's pretty cool. This is after the leave-in. It defines and clumps. So, just gonna put my oil mix and then get to the gel. Actually, just put oil on my ends and my hairline. So this is before the gel, just to leave in. And I do wanna try just wearing it like this sometime, like maybe next time. Cause I do feel like, you know, it did a good job of clumping my curls and I kinda wanna see how long it last. Now I'm gonna add the gel, which is Coiling All Curls Elongating Gel. So if you know me, I don't really care overly about elongation. I like my shrinkage, but I don't mind trying any gel that doesn't leave my hair crunchy, basically. So the gel has good slip as well. Like I probably wouldn't detangle with it, but just for actual applying to detangle hair, it's fine. So let's see. So I'm just raking in the gel. So this is it after shaking. So we'll see what tomorrow brings, but it looks good so far. So that was it. I can't decide which one blew me away more because the leave-in really clumped my curls and had like a soft hold almost, like I want to try it by itself. And the gel had no crunch, it's moisturizing, doesn't leave your hair flat. And it has good definition and it's elongating and everything. So this is like a day 3 wash and go. And I did kind of do some hiking and workout and stuff, but you can still see the definition. You still see the definition. And you can still see how, I guess, elongated it looks, you know? Without being flat and without being like weighed down and tacky and stuff like that. Plus, there's like no crunch and it's just really soft and moisturized. So I'm super happy. As much as I love the leave-in and I do, I can only name like 4 other gels maybe that are on my list of clean, moisturizing, hold for a week and no crunch. So adding this to the list is like big news. So I have the Camille Rose Curl Maker, Kinky Curly Curling Custom, Uncle Funky's Daughter Curly Magic, and now I have Jane Carter Curls to Go Coiling All Curls. So that's huge. But let me get into the review. Let's start off with the Curls to Go Untangle Me Weightless Leave-In. First of all, it wasn't particularly weightless. It was lighter than the Camille Rose Kids Line Leave-In, but that's what it reminded me of because it had that kind of creamy, you know, that creamy texture that kind of feels like it should be heavy, but it's not. But you can see it is kind of thick and it is really creamy. So I wouldn't call it weightless per se, but it's not heavy. It goes on really silky and nice, so that's good. The scent is like a perfumey scent, so it's kind of musky, but not really. It's like a in between light, florally, sweet and musky. But it's not super heavy. I think it's a nice scent. It's not like fruit or cake, which I guess is probably my favorite scent, but as perfumey scents go, I can definitely live with it. It moisturized my hair really well, defined my curls, plumped my curls, moisturized my curls. This leave-in definitely did right by me, and I'm definitely going to be doing a demo with just this leave-in alone in my hair in an upcoming video. So it might be a little tough to read it, because it kind of wraps around the bottle. You could probably use this alone for like a slight hole styling cream, because it has like this gum, which is a gelling agent, really high up. So that's interesting. It has water, it has the humectant, which is the glycerin, it has the fatty alcohol to help kind of retain the moisture, it has the guar gum for definition. The things like the mango seed butter, the marshmallow root, and so on are all really far down. Overall, it's in line with the Jane Carter MO, which is she's gonna put in whatever little chemicals and stuff she needs to get the formula to where she wants it to be. I don't use every single thing of hers, but her overall intention is to be clean, but she's not gonna be clean to the expense of the effectiveness, and she's not gonna be just all clean all the time. But this is clean enough for me, like I wouldn't really object to anything here. So if you look at her little guide, it actually does say curly or coily come through. So even if you don't consider yourself super curly, I think as long as you're curly, you benefit from this. But if your hair is actually kinky, coarse, etc., then this is going to be more like magic for you, because this is actually meant to eliminate frizz and really clump curls that are kind of resistant to clumping. So definitely does that. I would advise putting an oil between the leave-in and the gel, especially with people mentioning flakes. Next on parade, we have the Coiling All Curls Elongating Gel. So all the fragrance of both are the same, kind of perfumey. The ingredients on this is a little bit simpler. I probably still have to try to wrap it around because it's like kind of wrapped around the bottle. This one's actually a little cleaner than the leave-in. Pectin is the same thing that the Camille Rose Curl Maker has. It definitely has glycerin high up, but again, this is a good season for glycerin. Like spring, fall is a good season for glycerin for me, so no issues with that. I love pectin, it's very moisturizing. It's one of those things where you wonder like where the magic is exactly, because when I use pectin, the texture isn't like this and the effect isn't like this, but don't know if it was the hydrogenated castor oil or just some fancy mixing temperatures and stuff, but we have a winner. The texture of the gel, by the way, when you're pumping, like really pump, like press your palm down on the thing. Don't just, you know, pull your little fingers down, because I think that makes a difference in terms of how much comes out. But the texture of the gel is like a cross between Curl Maker or something slimy and Eco Styler or something. Like clear, like a Kabama based kind of gel. So it is a little bit slimy, but not really, you know? And it is a little bit like the clear kind of gels, but a little bit more slimy. So it is something in between. But it does go on pretty, you know, it does penetrate pretty well and stuff like that. So I like how my hair feels and looks, like it's just really soft, like no crunch. And it really has lots of volume, and this is a day 3 and it's nice and big and fluffy, and the definition is still there. So, you know, definition is still there. So I definitely recommend trying this. trying both. So I hope you enjoyed this review and demo. Let me know if you've tried it, and definitely try it. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye.